Hello friends, welcome to EduTap. I welcome you all in the rapid session of general awareness. We'll be discussing the most important current affairs from 18th to 20th of June 2021. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and join our Telegram channel for the free data and the notification of our session. The content which we are providing you friends is really very very helpful for your examination. Now we are providing you daily exam booster of general awareness, ESI current affair report and indices. Superstar of the session are Nekta Sharma, Dinu Priya, Anjali K, Amit Ram, Neil and your Mala Kumari who have given the right answer to the homework question below my video. I request everyone who is watching the video to please participate in this homework drill. It will be really very very helpful for your examination. Now question number one friends, Dash has sworn in as the new chief prosecutor of International Criminal Court. If I talk about the headquarters of ICC, they are present in Hague, Netherlands. Now friends, the right answer to this question is your option number B, that is Kareem Khan. But we will play with the option. Let's discuss all the appointments which are present in the option. Vikas Behl, I hope you remember his name, has been appointed as the additional judge of Punjab and Haryana High Court. I have discussed this in the previous video. Padma Kumar M. Nair has been appointed as the CEO of National Asset Reconstruction Company. I hope you remember this also. Sanjay Yadav has been appointed as the Chief Justice of your Allahabad High Court friends. And Anand Mohan Bajaj has been appointed as the Additional Secretary in the Department of Economic Affairs. Okay, as the member of your SEBI. I hope all these appointments are clear. We have discussed them in the previous videos also. Now friends, the British lawyer Kareem Khan has sworn in as the new Chief Prosecutor of International Criminal Court. He will succeed Fatou Bensouda of Gambia. Now if I talk about the headquarters of ICC, they are present in Hague, Netherlands. I hope this news is clear. Now friends, question number two. Which of the following countries has successfully launched Shenzhou 12 crewed spacecraft? And the right answer to this question is China. Now, we'll discuss about all the options. If I talk about China, I hope you remember that China has recently launched Heiang 2D friends, an ocean observatory satellite to orbit. Now, this satellite will give notification related to marine disaster and China will take preventive measures accordingly. Now, second is friends, I hope you remember that China has launched a new meteorological satellite naming Fangyung 4B to orbit. Now, this satellite will observe, will give weather analysis and your environment disaster notifications to China. Now, next is friends, Russia and China are together building world's biggest nuclear power plants in two Chinese cities. If I talk about China, friends, I hope you remember the capital is Beijing and the bilateral exercise between India and China is hand in hand. If we talk about Indonesia, that is our option number two. Now, friends, Indonesia, capital Jakarta. Okay. Bilateral exercise between India and Indonesia, name your Garuda Shakti. And friends, Indonesia submarine has been lost. Okay, so in the Navy was helping Indonesia to find its lost submarine. The name of the submarine is KRI Nanggala 402. We have discussed this news also. El Salvador, friends, related to El Salvador. Now, El Salvador became the first country, okay, in the world to adopt Bitcoin as its legal tender. If I talk about capital of El Salvador, that is San Salvador. Okay, and the currency is Bitcoin and US dollar. I hope this is clear to you. We have discussed this in the previous video only. If we talk about Israel, friends, I hope you remember the name of Isaac Herzog by Israel. He has been appointed as the president of Israel. And your Naftali Bennett has been appointed as the prime minister, has been elected as the prime minister of your Israel. Now, the capital of Israel is Jerusalem and the currency is Israeli new shekel. And Israel is surrounded by Mediterranean Sea, Red Sea and Dead Sea. I have shown this on the map also. Related to Iran, friends, I hope you remember that its warship named Kharg caught fire and sank in the Gulf of Oman. I hope, friends, all these things are clear to you. Now, let's discuss what the news says. Now, recently, friends, China has successfully launched Shenzhou 12 crewed spacecraft from the Zhiqiang Satellite Launch Center in the northwest China. Now, this Shenzhou 12 or Divine Vessel has been launched by using Long March 2F rocket. Now, this is the launch vehicle. Name of the launch vehicle. Friends, in this satellite, three male astronaut went to space? Okay, the name of them is Ning Hesing, Liu Mong Bombing, and your Tang Hongbo that have sent to your Tangyong space station. I hope this is clear. Now they have sent to this space station for 3 months on the 3 months mission. This much is clear, friends. Let's move forward and discuss the question number three. Who among the following has been named as the chairman of Microsoft, friends? Very easy. So the right answer to this question is Satya Nadella has been named as the chairman of your Microsoft. All the all the appointments which we have now, all these appointments we have discussed in the previous video. Let's revise them. Akriti Chopra, I hope you remember, discussed in the previous video, has been appointed as the co-founder of your Zomato. Okay. Next is Chandrasekhar Ghosh, friends, has been appointed as the MD and CEO of your Bandhan Bank. I hope you remember his name also. Ram Prasad Sirithan has been appointed as the MD and CEO of your Benetton India. K. Nagaraj Naidu, friends, has been appointed, has been named as Chef de Cabinet by United Nations General Assembly, President Abdullah Shahid. Now, friends, related to this Abdullah Shahid, we'll discuss one thing, that he is the foreign minister of your Maldives. Now, friends, Maldives capital is Male. I hope you remember this. And India Maldives signed an MOU on sustainable urban development. Okay, this much is clear, friends. Now, Satya Nadella is the right answer to this question. Now, friends, Microsoft named Satya Nadella as its new chairman. Okay, remember his name, important appointment can be asked in your examination. Satya Nadella would continue as chief executive officer's position as well. So he'll be holding two positions, that is the CEO as well as the chairman. I hope this much is clear to you, friends. Now, question number four. Which of the following states, Union Territory, has launched Corona-Free Village contest to encourage initiative to control the spread of COVID-19? And the right answer to this question is your option number D, that is Maharashtra. So option number D, Maharashtra, is the right answer to this question. Let's discuss about the national parks of all the states and Union Territories present here. If we talk about Kerala, friends, all the national parks related to the name Shola belongs to Kerala. That is Annamudi Shola, Mathiketan Shola, Pampadum Shola, Iravikulam, Periyar and Silent Valley National Park. If we talk about Andaman Nicobar Islands, then Campbell Bay, your Geth Bay, okay. Then your North Button, your Middle Button, your South Button, your Mount Harriet, and next is your Rani Jhansi National Park, Sedley Peak, and your Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park at the National Park of Andaman Nicobar Island. If we talk about Assam, friends, two new national parks has been added in the list and total of 7 national parks are present in Assam. Dibru Saikova, Manas, Nameri, Orang, Kaziranga, and now Raimona and Dhing Pattakai are the two new national parks which has been added in this list. If we talk about the national parks of Maharashtra, friends, which is the right answer, that is Chandoli, your Gugamal, Navegaon, Pench, Sanjay Gandhi and your Tadoba National Park are the national parks present in Maharashtra. If we talk about Rajasthan, friends, then Kevladev National Park, which is also known as Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary, Desert National Park, Draha National Park, Ranthambore Tiger and your Sariska Tiger Reserve are present in Rajasthan. Now, related to Rajasthan, in the previous video, one more news which we have discussed, that Rajasthan has announced, friends, to set up a Vedic Education and Sanskar Board. Okay. I hope all these things are clear to you. Now let's discuss Maharashtra is the right answer to this question. Maharashtra government, friends, has launched Corona Free Village contest. Okay, now this contest has been launched to encourage initiatives to control the spread of COVID-19. Okay, the contest has been launched under Maharashtra's My Village Corona Free initiative. Now, remember the name of the initiative as well as the state also. 3 village panchayat, friends, in each of the state revenue division will receive first, second and third prize. The prize money for the first position is 50 lakh rupees and second position is 25 lakh rupees and third position is 15 lakh rupees. I hope this is clear. Now next question, friends. Question number 5. Dash has planned to allow municipalities to issue paper-based vaccine passport. Now which of the following countries has announced to issue paper-based vaccine passport, and the right answer to this question is option number B, that is your Japan. Japan capital is Tokyo. Now let's discuss, friends. So recently, Japan has planned to allow municipalities to issue paper-based vaccine passport. Now this passport will be launched from July 2021 for Japanese traveler to travel abroad. Capital of Japan is Tokyo, friends, and the currency is Japanese yen. Remember this. Next question, friends. Dash has been named as the member of High Level Advisory Group, HLAG, on Sustainable and Inclusive Recovery and Growth. So the right answer to this question is option number A, that is Montek Singh Ahluwalia. Now friends, we will play with all the other options also. I hope you remember that RBI, okay, has recently launched a Regulatory Review Authority 2.0. I hope you Regulation Review Authority 2.0, I hope you remember. And M. Rajeshwar Roy will head this Regulation Authority. This was in news we have discussed. Now friends, next is Girish Chandra Chaturvedi. He has been appointed as the part-time chairman of ICICI Bank, friends. And with this, I remember Atanu Chakraborty has been appointed as the part-time chairman of your HDFC Bank. Remember him, his name also. Now friends, T. Ravi Shankar has been appointed recently as the fourth deputy governor, okay, of RBI. He have replaced B.P. Kanungo. If I talk about Mahesh Kumar Jain, friends, he has also been reappointed as the deputy governor of RBI. I hope this much is clear. And RBI has opened a liquidity tap of 50,000 crores to banks so that they can further lend this money and, you know, help to fight the second wave of coronavirus. I hope this much is clear to you. And your Bank of Baroda have sanctioned 500 crore rupees to your Serum Institute of India. I hope you remember, friends, all these things. I keep on revising them again and again. Done, friends? So let's discuss. So Montek Singh Ahluwalia, friends, has been named as the member of High Level Advisory Group, Sustainable and Inclusive Recovery and Growth. Now friends, HLAG is formed by your World Bank and International Monetary Fund, IMF. Now headquarters of World Bank are present in Washington DC. Okay, now friends, one more thing. The president of World Bank is your David Malpass. Remember his name also. Now friends, why this has been started? This has been started in the face of the dual crisis posed by COVID-19 pandemic and your climate change. I hope it is clear. Very simple news. Remember the name of Montek Singh Ahluwalia. Okay, I'll make you revise this again and again and make you learn it also. Don't worry. So next question, friends. A new targeted water bear moss piglet species has been discovered from which of the following state? Okay. So friends, the right answer to this question is your option number A, that is Kerala. Now friends, now Bihar is present here, and I hope you remember that Valmiki National Park is the national park of Bihar. Assam's national park, we have discussed Dibru Saikova, Manas, Nameri, Orang, Kaziranga, and your new national parks which has been added in the list are Raimona and Dhingpatkai. We have discussed this. Madhya Pradesh is Bandhavgarh, Madhav, Panna, Pench, Satpura, Vanbihar, Fossil, Kuno and Kanha are the national park of Madhya Pradesh. And Rajasthan's we have discussed previously also, and the right answer to this question is your option number A, that is Kerala. Now friends, let's discuss a new tardigrade. It is basically a water bear, friends. Okay, the water bear species has been discovered from the Vadkara in North Kerala. Okay, now new target species has been named, friends. The name of the species is important, can be asked in your examination. Remember its name. It is Tigetrus carolinensis. So it is the first species which has been, you know, discovered from Indian waters. Okay, I hope this is clear. And this is the image of the species. It is basically a water bear. Okay, clear, friends? So this is important because this was the first one which has been, you know, discovered from Indian waters. Its name is also important. Remember this. I hope this is clear. Next question number 8. Which of the following bank has extended USD? Okay, that is $10 million worth of line of credit to Sri Lanka to finance solar energy sector projects. So, now the right answer to this question is your option number E, that is your Exim Bank is the right answer. That Exim Bank, friends, has extended your $10 million worth LOC to Sri Lanka to finance solar energy sector projects. Now let's discuss about the options also. Now, I hope you remember Bank of Baroda, friends. Bank of Baroda become the first public sector bank, simply, okay, to sanction 500 crore rupees to Serum Institute of India. Now, Serum Institute of India is a vaccine producer company. The head, the CEO of Serum Institute of India is Adar Poonawalla, who has been recently appointed as what? I hope you remember that he has been recently appointed as the chairman of your Magma FinCorp. Clear, friends? It is a Pune-based company. Remember this. And Bank of Baroda became the first private sector bank to provide 500 crore rupees to Serum Institute of India under RBI's 50,000 crore liquidity tap. Okay. Now, related to Bank of Baroda, friends, we have discussed that Bank of Baroda has recently announced an e-auction of its to sell 46 of its non-performing assets. Clear, friends? Now, HDFC Bank, friends, Atanu Chakraborty has been appointed as the part-time chairman of HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank has announced to become carbon neutral by 2031 to 2032. Remember, this also related to HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank, okay, has launched Chatbot Eva, friends. Now, Chatbot Eva is for village-level entrepreneurs to discuss about their problems related to issues related to loan or their investments, etc. I hope, friends, all these things are clear to you. Now, ICICI is also present here, and we can remember the name again. Girish Chandra Chaturvedi has been appointed as the part-time chairman of your ICICI Bank, and Exim Bank is the right answer to this question. So, Export and Import Bank of India, Exim Bank, has signed an agreement with Sri Lankan government, friends. Now, under the agreement, what they have planned, under the agreement, the Exim Bank has extended your $10 million worth line LOC to Sri Lanka now to finance solar energy sector projects. Can be asked in your examination. It is important. Now, Sri Lanka has an aim, friends. Sri Lanka aims to achieve 70% of the national power requirements through renewable energy sources by 2030. This was the aim of the project. Now, related to Exim Bank, friends, headquarters are present in your Mumbai, Maharashtra. Clear? So, next question, number 9. India has appointed Dash as counselor in India's permanent mission in the WTO, World Trade Organization. And the right answer to this question is option number E, that is Ashish Chandokar. Now, option number E is the right answer to this question. Now, let's discuss about the option, friends. Vanita Gupta is present here. I hope you remember that she had become the first Indian American to be confirmed by your US Senate as the Associate Attorney General. Rekha Menon, friends, has been appointed as the chairperson of your NESCOM. If we talk about Arjun Kumar Sikri, friends, I hope you remember that he has been appointed as the chairperson of IAMAIS Grievance Redressal Board, discussed in the previous video only. Naftali Bennett has been elected as the president of your prime minister of your Israel, and the president of Israel has been elected. His name is your Isaac Herzog. Now, Israel has been, you know, surrounded by Mediterranean Sea, your Red Sea, and your Dead Sea. Capital is Jerusalem. I hope you remember, and the currency is Israeli new shekel. We have discussed all these things. So, Ashish Chandokar is the right answer to this question, that is option number E. Now, friends, recently India has appointed a private person, friends. The name of the private person is Ashish Chandokar as a counselor in India's permanent mission in World Trade Organization. Now, the headquarters of World Trade Organization are in Geneva, Switzerland. If we talk about Geneva, Switzerland, so I hope you remember World Health Organization's headquarters are also present in Geneva, Switzerland. If you see only Switzerland, then your International Hockey Federation's headquarters is present in Switzerland. And the president elected is Narendra Batra. I hope you remember this. Clear, friends? Now, friends, this much is clear. So, let's move forward and discuss about the news. Now, India has appointed a private person, Ashish Chandokar, as a counselor in Indian Permanent Mission of World Trade Organization. Okay, friends. For the first time, a private person has been appointed in the mission, friends, and Ashish Chandokar is a director of Bangalore-based policy tank, that is Samhai Foundation of Policy and Research. Remember this, friends, important for your examination. I hope this one is clear. Now, friends, question number 10. World Day to Combat Desertification and drought is observed on, it is observed on option number C, that is 17th of June. One announcement, friends, in the next video, I'll be taking a test of all the days of June plus their themes which we have discussed in the video. So please get prepared. In the next video, I'll be giving you a test which you have to perform related to days of June and their themes below my video in the homework section, and I want everybody to perform in this test. Basically, you can judge yourself that how many days and how many themes you remember for the exam. So friends, World Desertification and Drought Day is being observed on 17th June every year by United Nations. Okay, now friends, theme for 2021 is Restoration Land Recovery. We build back better with healthy land. I hope all these things are clear to you. It's time for the revision test, friends. Indian Bank has partnered with Dash to offer wealth management solution. You all have to answer this question below my video in the homework section. Astronomers at Dash has developed the first 3D map of the heliosphere. Please, everyone is requested to answer to this homework question and participate in the small drills. It will just take 1 minute to answer this question, friends, and obviously you'll be able to learn and retain this till your examination. So thank you so much, friends. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, do hit the like button. See you in the next video. Bye bye, and remember, I'll be taking a test on days and themes in the next video.